A fish kill is causing problems for Oklahomans. Hundreds of dead fish are leaving wildlife officials stumped in Noble County, and the problem could be heading this way. 2 News anchor Brianne Pomerani is live at the Arkansas River tonight to tell us about the concerns. Brianne.
Well, Karen, the game warden in Noble and Kay counties is concerned that whatever killed the fish there could continue to move this way. Now, he's afraid that whatever killed them is unnatural, but it will be up to the DEQ to make that decision, and they're not expected to have a firm answer for at least 10 days.
Well, normally you'd be seeing live fish, you know, coming up to the surface here on these riffles. You'd see a lot of gar and some carp and some species of buffalo. I don't see any activity other than a few turtles eating on some dead fish.
Spencer Grace is the game warden for Noble and Kay counties. What he's seeing now is disturbing, but this was the view a few days ago.
Fish in the water, gasping for air, hundreds and hundreds of fish.
Tim Glazier lives where the Salt Fork connects with the Arkansas River. He immediately called the game warden because he's never seen anything like it.
We've seen fish floating, and you could pick up 50-pound, 30-pound fish.
The big concern, what's behind this fish kill? Officials don't think it's a problem with oxygen, which is a common cause of fish kills during drought conditions.
The dissolved oxygen is not the issue. We're able to test that on site.
He says even fish kills due to the drought have not been this devastating.
It's not just fish that's died. I mean, the algae's completely dead. Freshwater mussels have died.
He has some theories.
And it's probably related to the conductivity in the water, which is salt and heavy metals.
But it will ultimately be up to the DEQ, and residents like Glazier want answers soon.
Everybody usually stocks up on fish during the summer, so they'll have fish all winter. We wouldn't eat the fish now for nothing. There's no way.
Well, I talked to the game warden here in Tulsa County. Now, he's calling this a wait-and-see situation because it depends on the DEQ's investigation and what that reveals as to whether that will impact fish here in Tulsa County. Live in West Tulsa, Brianne Pomerini, 2 News Works For You.
Thank you, Brianne. There is an interactive map on our website for you at KGRH.com where you can see exactly where this happened. And we will certainly continue to follow this story and update it just as soon as those test results are available.